Hey guys, and welcome back to Smart Money Mind. In our lifetime, we have to make some very important decisions. What career path to take, who we marry, how many kids do we want? But have you considered the cost of each of these life-changing decisions? In today's episode, we're going to be talking about the five most expensive life-changing events that we may not be ready for mentally or even financially. But once we make the choice to invest in these decisions, there's really no turning back. We often think about these experiences or see others experience it in some time in our lives, but we don't really think about the cost implications related to each of these experiences and events. So today I'm going to be telling you what I think the five most expensive life events are and give you some strategies on how to reduce the cost burden of each item. Number one is education. As fun-loving teenagers, we probably never thought about how we're going to pay for college or university. Well, at least I know I didn't. But I thought that it shouldn't cost that much, and if I did, then I would just go get a part-time job and pay for it. Boy, was I wrong.
Here's your taco, mister. Whoops, fell in the fryer. I'll get it out. Oh! Oh!
Tuition fees in the United States cost an average of $10,000 per year, and it could cost up to $30,000 to $40,000 if you're from out of state or out of the country. And that's a hefty bill for a pimply teenager whose most expensive purchase was probably a $70 video game. And with the minimum wage set at $7.25 on a federal level in the United States, let's just assume our student makes, you know, $10 an hour. He'll need to work at least 1,000 hours before taxes just to pay his education bill. And also, this is with nothing left over, so don't even think about eating cup noodles, you'll just not be eating at all. 1,000 hours is about 125 8-hour shifts. So our student here is working about 35% of the year full-time, and also he's going to full-time school. Students are basically forced to take student debt and student loans because there's no other option. No wonder students are coming out of college with huge amounts of debt. And according to this article, the average debt is $29,800 per student. Students coming out of college start in the negative by about 1 year's starting salary. So how do we expect them to live out on their own or even eat? They might as well go to their job interviews in their pajamas because that's pretty much all they can afford. The best way to set yourself up for success and overcome student loans and debt is to either borrow from a trusted parent or family member, or work earlier and start saving earlier, or just skip out on college and university altogether. Family members can be a great source of help, and if you're lucky, they might just pay your education for you. But even if you have to pay them back, likely it's with little or no interest rate. Working and saving earlier can also help your college career as well. I've known people who worked as young as 14 just to save some money. And thinking back, I remember just pissing away a lot of time, just doing nothing productive when I was in my teenage years. So even working 1 or 2 days part-time for a couple of years can get you really far ahead in funding your college. Lastly, there's always the option of just skipping out of college altogether, and maybe a good decision if you're deciding to start a business or do a career that doesn't really involve advanced education. Our second thing is marriage and weddings. Americans are spending an average of $35,000 per wedding, and Canadians are spending about $31,000. That's pretty much buying a car for a day, having a great experience with it, and then poof, that's it. Some people find weddings and marriages a huge deal, and that's, I can understand that, but does it really have to cost that much? It's great if both sides of the family can help pay for it, but what if you're on your own? Consider if having the best of everything is necessary. Remember that a wedding is between you and your significant other half, and so it's not necessarily for everyone else attending the wedding. As long as you find it special, others will most likely appreciate it as well. So marriage is also a thing that I find that is to keep up with the Joneses. so-and-so had this at their wedding, so I must have it too, or if not, I must do better than them. If they have an ice cream bar at their wedding, then I want a caviar bar at my wedding. Is one night worth your financial security for the rest of your life? That money could be better put in investments or in the purchase of your own home. To reduce costs, consider maybe having a brunch wedding, or maybe you can even do your wedding in your backyard. Having the wedding of your dreams doesn't mean that it has to be expensive. Number three is buying property. This could be your first home or your first rental property, but I can tell you it's going to be expensive. Depending on whether you live in America or Canada, prices can differ, but generally you'll need about $20,000 to $100,000 to put down for a down payment. And likely you'll need to pay for the rest of your life as well, at least for the next 25 years to 30 years. Buying property is your first step to real estate investing. Likely your property will increase that in value over time, but you gotta think about it, it's not just the down payment you have to pay for. You have to plan to get a mortgage and be able to pay that mortgage off every month. And also, you have to be prepared to pay extra for renovations or repairs along the way for your property. So this is where you have to have a budget and to schedule preventative maintenance to keep your property in tip-top shape. So having a couple thousand dollars in an emergency fund for your property is something that's smart to have, because you don't want to be having an emergency and needing to go out and borrow money at a high interest rate just to make this repair. Renting is also another option, but it's not always the most secure form of housing, as you're always under the control of a landowner, or you can always just live with your parents till you're 40. But whatever you decide, having a roof over your head is not an optional item. Number four on the list is raising children. And let's get straight to the point. It costs us, the average American family, $233,000 to raise a child from birth till they're 18 years old. Raising a child can be a beautiful thing, but to give your child the best start in life, a lot of financial preparation is needed to ensure that nobody ends up on the streets. Plenty of parents fail to plan and thus put their kids and themselves in financial jeopardy. Ensuring your kids have enough money for daycare, supplies, after school programs, etc. This is also a crucial part of parenting as well. And teaching them how to be smart with their money as they grow up and having money prepared for them even after they achieve adulthood is all part of the journey. Number five is death. You can choose not to go to college. You can choose to never get married. You can rent for your entire life, and you can choose not to have kids, but don't forget about dying. End-of-life costs, on average, is about $11,000. It's expensive to die, and so far, it's mandatory. So don't make it hard on your family and the people that are taking care of you. The simplest way to take care of yourself is to ensure that you have a will in place so that expensive lawyers don't have to get involved. Having a life insurance policy so that your next of kin can use that payout for your end-of-life costs. Or you can always donate your body to science, I guess. Regardless, the point is to have a plan of what to do with your rotting corpse. So, are you ready for these life-changing experiences and expenditures with it? In the comments below, tell me if you think you're financially ready for these fun events in your life. And make sure, if you enjoy this video, to like and subscribe to my channel for more awesome videos coming soon. And we'll see you guys next time.